women on boards, for me, I'm very passionate about women issues. I've been in a male-dominated environment from the time I was studying. In my engineering class, I must have been amongst a group of 10 other women. And then being in oil and gas, I was just completely surrounded by male colleagues. And that's really prompted me to join a network with like-minded women, professional women, that we can share and collaborate and learn from each other. And that's really why I've joined Women on Boards.
So, interestingly, I got into governance work quite by chance when I was approached in 2019 and the proposition was made for me to consider joining the board of John Paul College. So I did take it up and surprised myself by appearing for the elections at the annual general meeting. And I got voted in amongst very formidable candidates. That said, although I had the confidence of the shareholders and I had the required skills and experience that they were seeking, there was still something amiss and I felt rather unsure. I didn't feel the confidence that I felt previously in work situations. Looking back, I think I probably had imposter syndrome. And that's when I was, by chance, I came upon Women on Boards. And just the word got my attention. Women on Boards, and I felt there has to be something here that can help me. And when I researched further and delved into it, not only was I glad I found out about WOB, but I was quite relieved.
WOB has been that supportive network. It's like a sisterhood for me. And you know, I've only been on WOB for 14 months. But it's like this sisterhood of support that really has given me the courage and the self-confidence to be able to lean forward and step up.
Joining Women on Boards was like that first step. It was networking and connections, it was professional development, and I did my board CV masterclass with you. And I found it great for that. I mean, being in the regions, I did get a little bit jealous of the events run in Perth. It didn't quite time right for when I was visiting. And interestingly, my first WOB event in person was over in London. In 2019, I think it was. So I did get a lot of value out of it leading up to that. And fortunately now with COVID, so much more of it is online. But yeah, I've got so much out of being a WOB member.
WOB has, we were talking a little while ago, WOB to me has helped me, it's provided a safe place for me to learn, to interact, to have discussions with other directors, to discuss perhaps problems or issues that we're facing. And whatever we are facing on a board, someone else is facing on another board. So being able to share that knowledge in a safe environment, it's a wonderful culture that WOB presents. But I think during COVID, what WOB has done, where other member organisations shut down and took their bat and ball and went home to work in their lounge room, WOB actually stepped up and went in the other direction. The marketing was coming out. We were taught how to do Zoom meetings. We were advised how to get the lighting right and, you know, not actually wear your pyjamas while you're in a meeting. That was not appropriate, even though some people thought wearing their track pants was a good look. It really, for business, it really wasn't. And WOB went and gathered all the ladies and the women around Australia and internationally, for that matter, and brought their skills in and said, we've got all this risk going on now, the world is changing, no one really understands what's happening, how can we help all of the members of WOB get through this? And the courses and the availability was just huge, and a lot of those events that were online were free, so you could say, let's get on there and look at how the safe harbour regulations are changing, or how risk is changing, and what's happening in cyber, and how do you have to look after your members? Are there new laws around staff and in COVID, and could you be sued for this? So we were actually, it was a wonderful learning platform and it was very collegiate. And I think that was one of the main things for me.
Firstly, as I said, the first attraction was the name, that there was a space that was safe for us as women to come, to exchange ideas, to get to know each other's journey, our challenges. So that was hugely uplifting because I felt it was a safe space where I could actually communicate my desire to take on board roles without being considered presumptuous, which I may not have had that confidence if it was just a general forum. And I also found very beneficial the various webinars and workshops that Women on Boards has, especially the CV workshop, which I did with you and Ruth, the headhunters sessions. And I also must mention that I was massively impressed by how acutely aware Women on Boards is about cultural diversity. It first got my attention when there was a discussion thread on the topic, but I was blown away when then that translated into action and the Cultural Diversity Committee was formed. And I thought to myself, here is an organization that's serious about walking the talk. And for someone like me, that really inspired my confidence, and hats off for taking that initiative and making it known. And I would like those who are watching this to know that that's something that WOB is very serious about.
Hugely. Thank you very much. It's been fantastic. I mean, the people I've met through Women on Boards are extraordinary, some absolutely extraordinary women, including yourself. One of the things I love about it is it offers a space for a bit of vulnerability. You know, I think we get really different people coming into WOB, from new and aspiring directors to very experienced directors. And it is so good to have that space where people can connect and go, oh, I'm actually just not sure about this, and how can I manage that situation? And to do that in a really safe network. So to me, that's one of the strengths of it, and it's heaps of fun. We have a lot of fun.
Enduring, purposeful, and this is a phrase, really having a strong sense of enfranchising women on boards, which is so important.
So it would have to be diversity, I think, because not just gender, but cultural, age, race, all of those. I think WOB just does that so well, and I think it's really brought to the forefront how important that is on boards, and how that diversity makes boards so much better decision makers. That would be the first one. Then support, and I think the support that I see it as being really valuable is that involvement of new directors, bringing them up and in giving them the encouragement to be able to sit on boards. The third would have to be inspiration. I think I've listened to every one of your podcasts over the last 12 months, and to be honest, to listen to those women's journeys and the highs and the lows and the challenges is just been inspirational, and to realise at the same time to learn about really good governance because of the examples that they've shown has just been inspirational for me, and I'd have to say inspiration.
Supportive, collaborative, I can't just use three words. I think well-orchestrated organisation.
Leadership, transformation, and inclusion.
Three words to describe Women on Boards, I would say is comprehensive. So I felt right from get-go there was so many resources as well as the vacancies. Supportive, so there's that collegial spirit. You're approachable. You know, everyone's invited to participate online in forums. Guests are invited to events. You know, it's really, I think it is inclusive and approachable.
Women on Boards, I would say the first word is as an enabler and an advocate, because Women on Boards advocate for women to be on boards and the issues surrounding it. And what would be a third one? would be, I think, just collegiate, because of the nature of how, of the culture of women on boards, looking after and actually nurturing other women's careers. And it doesn't matter whether you're just starting out or whether you've been a director for many, many years. There's something there for everybody.
Empowering, facilitating self-development, and opening opportunities.
So I would say connection, I would say continuous learning, and I would say growth.